Hey YouTube, today I'm going to show you guys how to install Zandronum and how to set that up and make it so you can play Doom Online Multiplayer with mods with your friends. So this tutorial is for Windows. I will make a Mac one later. So go to a search engine, Google Zandronum. We're going to go ahead and go to the download section and then hit installer bundled with Doom Seeker. It's going to go ahead and download an installer. So you're going to go to your file manager and go to your downloads folder. And here it is. You're going to run this, and then there's going to be a UAC prompt. It's going to ask you yes or no. Hit yes. And then we'll get this. Make sure to keep everything default and hit install. So now we have Zandronum and Doomseeker. So Zandronum is the engine, the game's engine, and then Doomseeker is the online multiplayer server finder. So you should have a shortcut that appears on your desktop, so don't open that yet. I'm going to go ahead and show you how to actually put the game files into it. So to play this game, you need two games. You need Doom and Doom 2. So you'll have two files. You have Doom.wad and Doom2.wad. You can go ahead and pirate these. I don't condone that. So I'm going to show you guys how to get those two files legitimately by paying for them. But if you already have those two files, you can go ahead and skip to the timestamp in the corner below. So you can go ahead and buy them on Steam. So you can go Ultimate Doom. So Ultimate Doom is $5. And then you also need Doom 2. Doom 2 is also $5. So that's $10 if you want to go ahead and buy those. And then once they're downloaded, you can go to your Steam library and find them, Doom. And we can extract the files from these games. So these Steam versions of the game sucks, and they don't have mod support and no online multiplayer support, and it kind of sucks, right? So we can go ahead and right-click, Properties, Local Files, and Browse. So what we're going ahead and doing is grabbing those .wad files, which has all the textures and all the levels and things in them, and we're going to go ahead and put those into Zandronum. So base folder, and then we're going to go and grab doom.wad. So I'm going to copy this. Make sure not to overwrite this. And I'm going to go ahead and paste this onto my desktop here. So now I have doom.wad. And then we're going to go ahead and do the exact same thing for Doom 2. So Doom 2, right-click, Properties, Local Files, Browse. And now in this folder, we're going to go to Base and then find doom2.wad. I'm going to right-click, I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to put that on my desktop too. Now I have the two files that we need to actually play the game. So next, what I want to go ahead and do is put these into the Doomseeker folder. So to go to the Doomseeker folder in your file manager, you can go ahead and click this white space here, and you'll want to type C:\. And that will bring you to your hard drive. And you'll want to go to the program files x86, make sure it's the x86 one folder. Then you want to scroll down and find Zandronum. And then you want to go to the Doomseeker folder. So in this folder, this is where you actually want to put the game. So we're going to grab these two, and we're going to move them to the Doomseeker folder. So you need to be an administrator, so just hit continue. If you're on a school computer or a work computer and it doesn't allow you to do that, you're out of luck. So there it is. We have doom.wad and doom2.wad inside this folder, which is program files x86, Zandronum, Doomseeker. So that's all we need to do here, and now we can go ahead and launch the game. So this is the first time opening pop-up. It's going to try to tell us, hey, you need to install your game, and it's going to have other stuff here. We don't need that right now. So what we want to do now is, well, first of all, we want to update. You want to make sure everybody on your server is running the exact same version, or else it's going to be, you might have glitches and stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and update. Now my Doomseeker is updated. So what I want to go ahead and do is set our controls. So we could just join a random server, or we could host our own offline server, which is what I'm going to do. I'm going to go to File, Create Game, Play Offline. And then in this dropdown, you want to have either doom.wad or doom2.wad. If you don't see those, just type this exact same thing in. So I'm going to run doom, and I'm going to hit make sure that this is offline and hit play. So it's going to launch the game in single player mode. So it's going to be very loud, and the screen resolution is going to be the wrong size. So what we're going to go ahead and do is hit escape, options, sound options, I don't know if you can hear me there, to turn the sound off temporarily while we're doing the setup. I hit escape, I hit options, I went to sound options, and I turned the sound off. So that's just so we can hear stuff. So now we're going to set the video settings. So you can either use your mouse to go around this menu, or you can use your arrow keys, hit enter to go in one menu, and hit escape to go out of it. So I'm going to go ahead and use that. So I'm going to first of all set my display options, video mode. So if you want full screen, you can hit right and left on your arrow keys to turn that on and off. So if I hit it off, now it's in a window, on. So I like full screen. You'll want aspect ratio. You want to set that to 16 by 9 usually if you have a widescreen monitor. And then you want to go ahead and find 1920 by 1080 and hit enter on that. So now the game's going to be running in HD, which looks way, 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 way more better. So you can hit escape to go back one menu, and we're going to go ahead and set up our controls now because the default controls are terrible. So let's say I had a control that I hate, I can go ahead and hover over it with my mouse and hit the backspace button on my keyboard or delete, and that will make it go away, right? So I'm going to go ahead and set these. So fire, you want to be left click. Secondary fire, you want to be right click. Reload, usually want like R. Zoom, you don't really need. This is more of, some of these controls are for mods. The base game doesn't have these, but if you want to set them anyways, so C to zoom, use and open, instead of like open doors and stuff, and hit switches. So you want to set that to E. I think that's space by default, which is kind of, if you have jump set, then it won't work. Move forward, backward, left, right. Turn, you don't want anymore. You don't want to have bound. So if you have that bound, just hit delete. Jump, you want to delete that and set that to space. Crouch, I like left shift. If you want to have a crouch toggle button, I like to just hold it. You don't need flying controls. You don't need these. You don't need these. To run, so I'm going to go ahead and unbind these. This, you can hit control. You can swap the shift and control buttons if you want. You're more used to that. Strafe, you don't need a button. Chat, I'm used to Minecraft, so I like to set that to T. Most games don't have team mode, so you don't need to set that. These are fine, so mouse wheel down to go to your next weapon, mouse wheel up to go to your other one. These are fine. Activate item is fine for enter. Now these are the important things. So I don't have a page up and page down button on my keyboard. So usually you want to set these to, I have these set to Y and N, for one Y for yes, N for no. So when you're inside a server, people can vote, right? So it'll say vote now, and you can hit the yes in the corner, and it'll say yes, you want to vote yes or no. So you can vote kick other players, or you can vote to change maps, or you can vote to change modes and stuff, and everybody in the server needs to vote. So you need to have these bound when you're playing online. Join the game, you want to have space. It's default is fine. Some servers will have a custom message, and you'll be in spectator mode until you actually hit the space button to join the game. So make sure to have that set, and everything else is fine here. So when you're playing online, player setup is very important. You can type in a name. I usually have my name Duck. So to not look like a noob, you want to set your name to something else besides the default. And then you can change your color. So you can drag these red, green, blue sliders to go ahead and change your character's color. I usually do yellow. If you're on a modded server, you can go ahead and hit right and left on your arrow keys to change your class or your skin. And they have, some servers will have like hundreds of modded skins. I'm in the base game, so there's none here. Auto aim, you want to have always run, you want to have on. It's important for playing the game. So now I'm going to turn the sound back on. I set this to be kind of low so I can hear myself think. So if we wanted to play offline, I can go ahead and hit new game, and then I can, I don't know, choose this, right? Then I'm going to go into the first level. Things to keep in mind, if you are a speedrunner or something and you use this version of the game, I don't think that's allowed because this has a bunch of mods in it. So you can crouch to shift or toggle run is a button. And the original game from the 90s, you can't look up and down or jump or crouch. So that's the thing that's only in this engine. So if I want to go ahead and join a server, you want to hit quit game, yes. And then we can use this big, so we can close this now. You can use this big horizontal list here of servers to go ahead and join one. I'll make another video on how to host a server and use the original online deathmatch maps. That's just a little more complicated, so I'm not going to do that in this video. But you can hit the refresh button to get an updated list. If you have your friend's server is hosting one, it'll appear in this list, and you can type this its name in the search box. So let's say I wanted to join this server, right? So I can just double click it. And then the fun thing about Doomseeker is it'll download mods for you. So, hey, the server has a few different maps that you don't have installed. Just hit install and it'll do it for you, which is really, really, really nice. Don't worry about these taking up a lot of space. These are literally like kilobytes and megabytes. So these won't even, your Doom folder will never be over a gig. So it's a very, 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 very small game. Even if you have hundreds of mods installed. So we're going to go ahead and open this. And now we just wait for the server to start up. So now it's going. So when you see this, you know it's working. So it says, join my Discord. So I'm in spectator mode right now, as you can see, because I have no, you can't see my gun or anything like that. You see the spectating text in the middle? So this is when you'll hit space and hit join game. So now I'm actually in the server. So I think I'm in a server with bots right now, I believe. I don't know. So you can go ahead and hit open doors and hit switches with E, like we bound in the menu. Whenever you see Duango maps online, those are the original deathmatch maps that were used in the 90s. So these are the actually good maps. Because if you play in the single player campaign maps, that they're not exactly laid out very well for fighting your friends and stuff. So here's a double rear shotgun. So let's say I wanted to call a vote, right? So I hit escape here, and then I believe I go to multiplayer. So call a vote here. So let's say I wanted to vote for a new map. So I'll go here, and let's say I want to vote to change the map to map number 5, right? I'll do that and hit, I can type in a reason, lol. And then hit vote, right? So now it'll say vote now, and everybody will hit Y or N on their keyboard. So I'm going to hit yes. I'm the only person in the server. I think these other guys are bots. So the vote passed, and then it'll go ahead and switch the map. And then everybody needs to hit space and join the game again. And now we're on a different map. I'm going to go ahead and quit the game here. So I hope this tutorial is helpful. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments below. I'll make sure to get to them within a day. I'm going to go ahead and make a Mac version of this tutorial as well, and then another tutorial on how to host a server. Which is very similar to how we did this offline, but there's some things that you'll need to know, and you'll have to download some maps to use for that. All right, thank you for watching. Take care.